So, Saras, thank you for sharing them with us.
Thank you.
Let's start the procedure with the interview. Žalgiris made the previous season, you know, its best EuroLeague run in the last 20 years, the best since the mythical season of 1999. So, how hard is to achieve, keep your team at the same level, or even take it farther this season?
Look, we don't have to think about that. This is what we didn't think about it last year. You know, we didn't think about it that we're going to go somewhere. This is the mentality that we have to establish, is to go game by game. I mean, a lot of big teams, so to speak, you know, they try to come in the right moments at the right time. But with this EuroLeague, with the new way of so many games, it's not possible. So the only way, I believe, is to go, you know, game by game, one game at a time. And this is my biggest, you know, this is what I try to do the most here, just not to look past the next game.
Okay, what's most difficult, to control and lead the team as a floor manager in the court with the basketball in your hands, as you have done through your career, or to lead and control a team from the bench?
Oh, from the bench is much more difficult. Everything with the coaching profession is really a difficult profession, you know, because ultimately, if you want to do things right, you know, you have to worry about a lot of things. You know, you have to worry about media, you have to worry about the traveling, you have to worry about your daily life scheduling. Basically, you have to worry about 20, 30 people, and sometimes you even think about, if you want globally, you have to think even about the fans, you know, their situation. So, you know, you have to worry about a lot of things. But okay, I can't play anymore, you know, so this is the closest thing to playing, and this is the only thing I know how to do in life, so I'm very lucky to be having this job and this opportunity.
Yeah. The nights before the games, do you have, you know, easy sleeps, or are you overthinking strategies and reactions by imagining what could be the case in the upcoming game?
Now, with every year, less and less, you know, it's becoming more of a routine, you know, and so on. Before, when I just got the job, I was very nervous. I wasn't sure, you know. Now you're more sure. You went through the things, you know, many times, and experience help a lot, you know. So with every year, you're gaining more and more experience, and no, I have much easier sleep now at night.
Good. Clubs like Žalgiris need different type of skills and perspectives for their recruiting team compared to teams like CSKA, Real or Fener. You're getting the point.
Well, I think you know, teams like CSKA and Fener, there's no way they can really sign an up-and-coming player. I mean, they need to go more of the sure product. I think we must go at the a little bit with the instinct, a little bit with our information, a little bit of everything, trying to understand who can be very good EuroLeague player in 5-6 months, in a year sometimes. Yeah. You know, I think Fener, CSKA and Barcelona and all these teams, they want a very good player right now. And, you know, okay, it's everything is fine, you know. I mean, we just have to understand always who we're working for, what is our situation, and deal with it. And I'm very lucky that I'm surrounded by the people who understand what exactly club we are, who we are.
As far as I remember you are, you know, one of the most passionate guys ever. As a player or coach, your willingness to win, sometimes, you know, it's close to madness. So this is something you developed through the years, or you are born with that?
I don't know. I believe that I don't know, something happened when I was maybe tasted the first success. You know, you kind of become addicted to it, and at the same time you have to understand how difficult it is to achieve that. So, you know, you have to push yourself constantly. You know, you have to push yourself constantly first, and because I believe everything starts with yourself, you know, first, and then you know, as a coach, I must push my players, you know, and sometimes I'm even asking players to do a little bit more than they're capable of. But I believe there is no other way. I think it's the same for, if you coach Žalgiris, if you coach for any other team, you just have to find a way for your players to give maximum, and sometimes even, you know.
But you know, you have proved that you have you know, the mentality to be hungry all the time. How difficult is to transit it to the players, like personalities?
I don't know. I mean, it's not that difficult. I mean, it's the only thing I must do. I mean, I must try to help my players to be hungry all the time. I must stay hungry all the time. You know, it's. But I'm very lucky because I have these type of players. You know, they work hard every day. They seem to be motivated every day. You know, the atmosphere in each practice, it's very competitive. So as a coach, this is, you know, the maximum you can ask for.
Yeah. As an observator of your career, I have the sense that when you are about to take an important decision, you are mixing your feelings with the facts in order to make the decision. First of all, is that true? And if yes, do you think that this is the right, you know, approach for a professional of your level?
I think as a player, yes. As a coach, no. I try to really rely a lot on the facts as a coach, because as a player, it's very simple. You come and you play. You try to go to the best coach and so on. As a coach, you really need a lot of things around you. You know, you need one of the most important things is you need the president who understands who you are, who understands your weaknesses and your strength. The president who understands the club that we are, not to have, you know, ridiculous ideas and ridiculous expectations. So this is the reason why, like I always said, I'm working for the most perfect club in the world, possibly, for me, because they understand me, they understand where I'm coming from, they support me, you know, and it's very difficult to find that in Europe. And when you start talking to the other clubs, you understand that it's very difficult to find what I have in Kaunas.
Yeah, because it's different mentalities, way of thinking.
You know, I mean, you know, some people, they just quite simply don't understand basketball, and because they are the owners or they the CEOs, whatever, the head of the board of the directors, they understand, they think they understand basketball. No, most likely your profession is something else. So, you know, if you don't understand that, this is already the biggest problem.
How is it for you to clear that, you know, in every person that you are talking for the job, that this is your part, stay out?
I think the only way is to be very honest with yourself and with the person. There is no secret. I think there you have to exactly come together, talk, and what is our expectations, what is our ideas, and can we work together? But, you know, it's very simple. You know, if I'm building a house, I cannot tell too many things to architect, you know. I mean, I just don't know about architecture. So it's the same comes to basketball.